just got this type of video, so be gentle. Weather's just about dried off enough this year. What are we now? We're end of April, and just about dried off enough to start doing outside jobs again now. So a couple of years ago, I started resheeting or restoring an old Dutch barn I've got at my place here. So I'll spend it and walking around it. It's a three bay jobby with a lean to. I've done the two main bays of it with a mate a couple of years ago. So I've got a bit of cover back, originally made by a local company in Whitchurch up there. The sheets are also made by a local company, different one, in Whitchurch. So, yeah, that's a bit of a walk, well, half around it. I've been stripping the framework, removing the old sheets. That's a few of them. Stripping the framework, cleaning them with the angle grinder with a twisted wire cut brush in. Horrible job, but someone's got to do it. And could get it shot blasted. Access to this place is a nightmare. So once I've cleaned it with the wire brush, I put a Genolite rust killer on it. Converts the rust. It says it converts the rust. Then a primer and a coat of top coat. And it turns up grey. All right. If you look closely, it's a bit ropey, but I'm happy with it. It'll give it another 50 odd years. It's been here since the 40s, I believe. So it's hopefully give it another same again. Do me for my old tractors and the tap that I love. So I'll put you on time lapse and you'll see me in a bit. It's now a few hours later on, 4 hours or something like that. I've got a bit done, got a couple of trusses. Hoped I would get all this top lifter scaffold clean and done today, but I haven't. Show you around. The sad thing is, it doesn't look that much different to how it did before, unfortunately, but you can see. Algae on this because a lot of the roof has been gone, I don't know, 20 odd years or something. So there's a lot of just junk, rust, all sorts on there really, so I'm just trying to get that off best I can before I put rust killer on it. So another, I hope to get it finished tomorrow, but probably a couple of days of cleaning, a day on this top lift, a day downstairs, and then hopefully I can get on with the rust killing. A day or so for that, a day or so for priming, a day or so for top coat, and then I can start sheeting, but I'll need to rope in the help of a mate with that. So not heavy sheets, but working at height, you need somebody on the inside putting the bolts on, somebody on the outside. So I'll just show you in the bit we've already done. This is the that's it. We're done. So it's housed at the bottom. barn is used to house my tat, old boogies and stuff like that, which you like. Diggers, trailers, tractors, implements, just all sorts of... I'm not a farmer, but I like farming stuff. So anything I can use to make life a little easier here. There's 4 acres or so to mow, keep on top of, so do a bit of mowing, a bit of harrowing, grading, or stuff like that really if I need an implement. If I can get one for the Fergie, either the red one or the grey one, I will. Right, that's it for now. See you tomorrow. One thing I forgot to mention actually is a scaffold. I've got a quick stage, got a few towers, so I've got quite a lot of quick stage here. I think 16, 17, 18 bays, so may as well use it. But it's still only enough to do half a barn at once. So it takes me a few days to put the scaffold up, a day or so to take it down, a day to clean each bay, a day to do each coat of each bay, so it's certainly a few weeks of work. Put new gutters in, I've put new drains in, surface water and rainwater drains to catch. It's a fairly big roof area this, so a bit of rainwater to catch, so I've got that going into a separate soakaway, separate from the house system anyway. Yeah. So to show you the sockets, so here goes. The armoured cable P-clipped every 400mm. I'm going to raise the level of the haunching concrete at some point. I've been marking some datums with me laser level yesterday evening. So if you can see, I don't know if you can see that, but the top is the datum, which is taken from that very far corner, the highest corner, and I want a slight fall. So I've been setting each pole 100mm lower, each pole, each vertical column, 100mm lower than the previous one in two directions, so there's a fall on it all. So I've been raising that, and that's kind of been determining my gutters. So haven't really got much to show you yet, just watch my head. So here we are up the scaffold, so to show you the guttering. Don't really know what there is really to show you, to be honest. I did say I would, so here we are. Watch this. Gaps. So it's not in its final position, you can see a couple of dips in it down there, but the brackets all get screwed from underneath.
but I can't do those until I've put the curved roof sheets on to know exactly where the gutter brackets will sit, because they kind of sit in the corrugations of the tin sheets. So I've got to do the roof, and typically the curved roof is the last of the jobs to do. I've got to do this flat roof first, and before I do the flat roof, I've got to do the two and a half sides of the lean-to. So, got a bit to do. I'll go up and I'll show you the gutter brackets. I'm sure I've got some new ones, a couple of spares, so I can show you them. Right, gutter brackets. That was one of the existing ones, one of the better ones, so I gave that to the blacksmith, and he came back with that, which I think is pretty good. I've got him to drill every one for an M8. M8 in, so you can kind of see the gutter. It's only this lightweight plastic junk, but should do a job. You can see just there, I'm screwing every other gutter bracket down, and they hook over the angle of the edge of the steel that supports the edge of the sheets. So it's all nice and old-fashioned, apart from the neoprene. I put that to stop the tin rubbing on the angle, because I'm too fussy with things like that. Another thing to show you, I put the extra supports. I did those a couple of days ago. They need another coat of paint. I'm going to paint the fasteners all grey, just so they all match, because again, I'm fussy. I've got a few more bits of touching up to do. All the grinding of the back of the tech screws for holding the gutter, the downpipe brackets, and the power, the armoured cable. I've been grinding them back, so they will need a coat of primer, coat of top coat again. So I'll have a bit of touching up to do another day. But nearly there. Just got my mate booked in now for Tuesday. What are we now? I forgot to say it's Friday now. Friday afternoon. I think it's the 10th of May. So in a week or so, hopefully get some more filming and sheets going on. Start with the lean-to, like I said. Curved roof will be the last of the job. Sorry about the noise. The farmer next door's cutting his hay or silage or whatever he's doing. Just started that today, so apologies for the noise. I haven't listened yet to see what this sounds like. I haven't got an external microphone. This is just on the GoPro, so let me know. Well, if anyone watches, let me know and maybe get a microphone. I know most people seem to have them, or the people I follow do similar things to me. Right, that'll probably be it for today. I'll finish his downpipes, and then I think it's a case of touching up where I've taken the paint off or missed bits or whatever, and next you'll hear from me will be probably Tuesday with my mates here. Tuesday evening, I think, or a few evening, a bit of boys' nights, love them. And working, well, it's a bit of a holiday, but working holiday, I think, for my mate, so see you in a bit.